here, first one is the meristematic tissues. In meristematic tissues, further we can divide into three types. One is the apical, second is the lateral, and third one is the intercalary type of meristematic tissues. So all these position we can see in a plant. So I'll draw one picture for you so you can understand the apical and the lateral and the intercalary meristematic tissues position in a plant. So I'm drawing a single picture, if you can see. Here you can see this picture. At the top, you can see this tip portion. This tip portion or the top portion is made up with the meristematic tissues, which is called apical meristem. That means apical meristem is found at the top. And second one is lateral meristem. This lateral meristem is found at the lateral sides of the stem or roots or maybe stem. And intercalary is found between the two internodal regions. So here, this is the region. Here, intercalary type of meristematic tissues are found. So with the help of these meristematic tissues, the cells divide at the top and plant grows at the top region. So it can tall when lateral type of meristematic tissues divide, then width of the stem increases, and when intercalary type of meristematic tissues divides, it divides and its length of the side branches increases. So these are the basic main functions of the meristematic tissues. So in simple words, we can say meristematic tissues are those tissues which have the capability to divide again and again when plant growth is needed. And these type of tissues are found at the top, at the lateral side, and at the intercalary region, or we can say at the internode region of the plant. So here you have seen the meristematic tissues which have the capability to divide, and here we can divide into three parts: apical, lateral, and intercalary. Now we will see the permanent type of